Hey everyone, welcome to another tutorial where I'm going to teach you everything there is to know about procedural objects. This is one of my favorite mods that I use in my cities because it is extremely versatile and you can do crazy things with it. Here are a couple of my creations that I did with this mod, and if this looks complicated to you right now, don't worry, because by the end of this tutorial you will have a much better understanding of this mod and how you can work with it to create the things you need for your beautiful cities. I'm going to make this a three-part series, sort of beginner, intermediate and advanced, where in each episode I'm going over some of the functions of this mod and what you can do with them with practical examples. So let's start with the first tutorial. Today you will learn what are layers, exported objects, how you can move, scale and rotate an object, how you can color a procedural object and how you can customize an object. I recommend you to not skip ahead so you don't miss out on important parts, and don't worry, I will try to make this as short as possible, but we are going to do everything live in game and with actual examples and different tips and tricks so you can have a better understanding. Alright, let's go. So over here I have a cube, and the first thing that you're gonna notice once I click this button, procedural objects, is that we are in selection mode. Basically we can select procedural objects. This is a procedural object and we can see it because it has this plus sign. Once I hover the mouse over it, it's gonna select the area, the cube, by highlighting it with red color. This is especially useful because you can see how many I have over here. Because you can see what you are working when you are selecting those things. So you can see everything that I have the mouse hovered over, it's gonna turn into red. So this is useful because when you have a lot of objects together, sometimes it becomes a mess and it's really hard to find out which object you wanna work with. Okay, so right now we're in selection mode. If we click on this object, the first thing, we have this menu here, so we can edit it, move it, copy it, set layer, align heights and delete. And we also have this little button here. This is really really cool because now you can color procedural objects. So you can make them darker, lighter, you can make them whatever color you want. Okay, so now you learned something. And let me show you what does align heights do. So if we go into edit mode, we go to general tool, and here we have this gizmo which represents the 3D axis. So we can move it by dragging this thing here, so I'm holding left mouse button to move it in that axis, or I can do it in this axis. I cannot move it in any other direction or upwards. Okay, so if I position this thing over here and let's say I want to make a copy of it and I'm going to paste it over here on the ground, I want it to be the same height as that one, so I can click on align heights, and now it's going to ask me which object you want to align the height with. So I'm going to select this one. And right now both objects are at the same height. Okay, and one more thing, when let's discuss a little bit about copying objects. So once I copy this thing, okay, I click copy and you can see that I still have this object selected. I right click to unselect this one, okay, so it's unselected, and I just press Ctrl V to place it. And right now if I click left mouse button, I'm gonna place the object. Okay, but I don't want it to be like that. I want it to be the same height. So once I copy this one, it's gonna remember the height of this object. So before placing it, I can hold H on my keyboard. So by holding H from height, I can have it the same height. So I can align it over here with my mouse and try to match it as best as I can and place it there. Okay, now if you are gonna zoom in perfectly and be super OCD about it, you're gonna see that I haven't placed this perfectly. So that's annoying. How can we deal with that? Well, the new procedural objects update does a wonderful thing at copying objects by going to edit mode, clicking on general tool, and once we can see this gizmo here, we can hold control and then drag this part here. So I'm gonna hold Ctrl and click on this axis because I want to go in that direction, okay? And by holding Ctrl, we are duplicating the object. If you ever work with Photoshop or whatever, you know what this thing does. It's duplicating in one axis. So now I can place it perfectly on this axis. So I'm just gonna move it here. Okay? So the best thing about this is now that if I make another copy, it's gonna remember how I placed those two and it's gonna snap to the correct location. So see, it's just snapping over there. This is really cool if you want to make, for example, let's find plastic pipe. So I'm gonna turn this into procedural objects. Let's say I wanna make an area here with more plastic pipes. See how fast it is. And then over here on the gizmo, again we have position, the first one. The second one is scale, and you can scale things up and down and left, right, and so on. And rotation, so we can rotate those objects as we want. Okay, so we can just go to scale, and I'm using page up to make those bigger. And I want to move this over here. And again, in position mode, hold control and make a few more of those pipes. And yeah, you can go crazy with this and have different things. A thing that I want to explain to you, actually, let's go over rotation mode as well. So, because I haven't showed that. You can find those right now. We are in customization tool because we see those vertices. But let's finish with the rotation. So we go general tool and we have position, scale, and rotation. So we can rotate this object around this axis. Okay, so it's just gonna go like this, or we can rotate it horizontally like this, or on the other one like this. Okay, and whenever you're not satisfied with something, you can always press Ctrl Z to undo. Alright, now let's go into customization mode. So right now we are in customize tool, and you can see those little dots here. What are those dots? Those are vertices. I just found out today that the plural is vertices. The singular is vertex. So a vertex is where three or more edges meet up. So we have this edge here, this one here, and this one here, forming this vertex. And all this cube is forming, let me move it over here so you can see, all this cube is making those eight vertices, okay? And we can manipulate them as much as we want, however we want. So we can select one vertex and we can just move it, we can move it in that direction. We can move it higher by pressing page up. You have all those buttons here, the shortcuts. And let's say I want to make the base a bit lower, so I'm selecting all of those. And I can also hold control to select more. So again, I'm selecting only those and pressing page down to move them down. And let's say I want to be precise with this. I can hold shift and alt key. This is my preferred method to fine tune the adjustment. So we can go like that. All right. And this becomes extremely useful because you can modify buildings and all that kind of stuff in the way you want. There is one thing to mention, you cannot delete a vertex. Even if you select only one of them, if you press delete on your keyboard, it's gonna delete the entire object because all of this is connected, so you cannot simply delete one. The game doesn't know how to fill the empty gap with. Okay, now let's discuss a little bit about layers. So we have this cube here, and let's say I'm going to customization mode and I make this a bit thinner like that, let's say something like that, and then I want to scale this higher. I press page up, okay, like so, and I want to duplicate it a few times. The same trick, I'm holding control, I'm aligning them perfectly, and then I just snap and snap and snap, so it's gonna be perfect. But let's say this might be too high, so let's move it closer to the ground. And like I showed you earlier, we select those objects and click on align heights with that one. Okay, so let's say this is already looking like a bus shelter or a tram shelter or whatever you wanna make out of this. Let's say I wanna do some work here on the ground right now. I wanna place some street, I wanna place some benches, some parks and whatever. But I can't zoom there, I can't work like this. So what you can do is go into procedural objects, click on layers, and let's make a new layer. And we are gonna call this tutorial. Very original. And I click on plus, so we have tutorial. What we can do now is select all those objects and assign them to the tutorial layer. As you can see, I already have a couple of them. So those are now assigned to the tutorial layer. Now, if I click back on layers here, I can click on this eye to hide them. So this is extremely useful because now I can work on the ground level, do my things, and once I'm done, I can place those back. To show you a better example how I use this, and I don't want to spoil too much of the city because I still want to make some episodes for you. Let me find where that thing is. Okay, so over here I made this bus station. Again, the entire roof here, this interesting piece of art that I did, is made with procedural objects, but it was really hard for me to place all those flowers and bus shelters here and all that. So what I did was assign all of them into a layer, and I have this bus terminal roof. I hide that, I do my thing, place the lines, place the decals, place everything that I need, and once I'm done I can just turn the layer back visible. Alright, so this is really really useful. Let me go back over there to my test area, area 51. Okay, so that's how you work with layers. Now, what is an exported object? So in the same way, we can export all of those into an object. This is really useful because you will have them forever. They are stored locally on your hard drive and you can place them whenever you want, as long as you have the object in subscribed. For example, the way I use this, you can use it in so many ways. Just think about when you want something to be repeated a couple of times, so you don't have to do it over and over and over again. But a cool way that I want to show you, I'm just going to give you a few examples, so just to make a demonstration here. Let's go parking decal. You already probably know where I'm going with this. So let's add one there, one there. I'm not gonna align them perfectly, so you just get the idea. Okay, and we have some cars. Alright, so I'm gonna place a car here, one there. Let's find a couple more different ones. So let's use those. Again, I'm not doing this perfect, I'm not aligning things as they should be, I'm just trying to show you an example here. Okay, so let's say we have those. A good tip for you is always turn props into procedural objects to save on the prop count. So you can do this with Move It mode very easily. I click on this button here, I select only props to select all the cards and turn them into, convert them to procedural objects. Okay, it's gonna take a bit of time, not that much. It's gonna convert each and every car into procedural object. And now if we go on procedural objects, we can see all those objects because we are in selection mode, so we can select all of them and we can click on export button. Watch carefully because this is a bit weird sometimes, but I click on export. Okay, I deselect everything, so all those cars are exported. And now if we go into exported objects, I'm gonna have to click refresh. See, it's not showing up here. So I click on refresh and we have this new thing, selection Monday, May 11 at this hour. So I'm gonna rename this and give it the name tutorial. You're gonna make a good name for this, so you remember in the future. So now whenever I wanna fill in quickly parkings, I can just click on this place button and it's gonna take out all of those cards over here. So I can do this over and over and over again. It's gonna be really really useful. Okay, so that's how you work with exported objects. Let me delete this. All right and now let's cover more customization things. So we talked about layers, exported objects, how you can color them, how you can move, scale them and so on. So let's talk about more advanced, let's say, customization of objects. One more thing I want to mention is that when you scale things up, you are always going to scale them from the center, outwards and inwards. Let me show you. So let's take this for example. I'm going to place it over here. Okay. Let me make sure that the terrain is flat for what I'm about to do. One second. And let's drag a road in front of the house, something like that. Okay, and right now this is a functional building, but I want to turn it into procedural objects because for some reason I don't like this roof here. It really annoys me, and with procedural objects you can get rid of it. So I'm gonna go into procedural objects. Oh, the building is not converted, my apologies. Again, we click on this building and convert into PO. By the way, you cannot turn vanilla buildings or vanilla props into procedural objects. Okay, keep that in mind. Now it's gonna take a bit of time because it has to convert all those edges, all those things into vertices. So yeah, another thing is some of the buildings will lose some details because the creator, when he did this building, he made the model, and then some of those areas he added his own fences which are part of the game or whatever, so you're gonna lose those, but no big deal. Now let's see what happens if we go into edit mode and readjust the building up and down and click on edit. It's gonna take a bit of time because it has to select all the vertices and everything, but don't worry, the game didn't freeze, it's just normal. Look at this mess. So I click on general tool, and as you can see, if I lift this building a bit higher, the other details from the ground are going to show up. So let's just align this with the road. Of course, this is not specific to, this is not a general rule. You have to play with every building. But we lost the fences. We can add them after that and flowers and all that. But I just want to show you how customization works. Okay, so now with this building selected, I'm going to go into customization mode, and we see all the vertices that make up this object, this building. But we are going to focus on the ones over here on the roof. So if we go like this, it's hard to select. So it's a bit of camera work. You have to place your camera somehow so you can see only the vertices that you don't want. So over here, I can already see I don't want those. So we can hide those. Oh, and we have a problem. See, it goes together with the roof. I can press Ctrl Z. So that means we select the vertex which makes part of the roof of this part here, this part where my cursor is. We don't want that, so I have to fine tune my selection. So I'm gonna select those. With practice, the more you do, you will start to understand which vertices you have to select and so on. So I probably selected this one because if you see here, it connects the roof. So look at that. Okay, and I'm just holding page up and page down. I'm pressing page up and page down to move those into the building so we cannot see them anymore. Okay, so let's move this, and now I want this to be hidden. This is really, really useful if you want to get rid of different air ducts or vents or whatever things from a building which you don't want. Now again, not everything can be hidden. Sometimes it's really tricky to do this, but most of the cases you can work with this quite well. Let me quickly do all of this. Sorry, one more time, my mouse is making really funky movements. Okay, let's hide those vents from here and those ones, and now all this big mess over here. I want to show you what you can do with this thing. So let's hide that and just a couple more over here. Alright, and now we hide all the roof there. So what we can do now is maybe grab a grass ploppable surface. We can turn this into a procedural object. Okay, convert into PO. And I'm gonna lift it in the air by holding page up, and I'm just gonna try to align it with the edge over here, looking at this corner here. And of course it is kind of floating right now, you can see this gap over here. So I'm just gonna go into edit mode like I showed you, and position, we select the height axis, and I'm just gonna move it kind of there just to hide the roof. Okay, so now I can just hold Ctrl, make another copy here, and go in that direction and just fill out the entire roof here. I did it a bit wrong because the axis is a bit messed up, but no big deal. Now we have this thing we need to edit, so I'm just gonna select the vertices here, and I'm just gonna move them inside over here, and we kind of need another small one there. I just copied, hold H and place there. Okay, and now we can just find some trees and we can add them over here on the roof, make a nice pretty eco-friendly climate change prevention roof. So can do something like that. Okay. Or we can turn other buildings into procedural objects and place them on top of this building and maybe place a road behind them so it looks better. Just like I did over here, you can see it's the same principle, but those are functional on the bottom. They have a road access, and those ones on the top are procedural objects. You can see that because once I select this plus sign, you can see those are procedural objects. And I have another example over here. Okay, so I add those commercial buildings on the bottom here, and I drag this road, and I have those little other buildings placed on top of the buildings on the bottom. So it looks really cool. We have a babushka here. Alright, so I hope you understand this principle, this concept. And now let's try to... one more thing I want to show you about the scale. So let me go into edit mode, make a copy of this object. I'm so used to copy those objects now with the by holding control instead of copy and paste, because it's so much faster. But so let's make a copy of this. And if we go into scale mode, like I said, everything is gonna be scaled from the center, outwards or inwards. So from the center of the object, if I click over here, see how it stretches. Basically, scaling is more like stretching. This is useful if you want to make objects bigger or smaller in size. Because if we are in this mode, in scale mode, you can see here the shortcuts. You can press page up, page down to make to scale the object in scale mode. So you can hold page up and it's gonna go in all direction equally. So it's gonna keep the ratio. But if we select only those axes over here, it's gonna stretch from the middle, and sometimes you don't want that, because if we go like this, look what happens with the balconies and everything. They just get stretched so much, and sometimes you don't want that. Same goes for the other direction, and same goes like this. It's always from kind of the middle. Alright, now let me show you another cool thing which you can do by customizing different things. So let's say I added I'm just trying to imagine some scenario where you will find this useful. So let's say I have that over there, and I have another road which goes about here, maybe something like that, and let's leave this higher up until there, kind of like that. Okay, and let's make this a bit longer. Okay, so let's say I have over here this thing, and I want to add some buildings on this part here. But first of all, let's add some grass. I'm just wanna repeat some of the principles you already learned, so I can convert this ploppable grass into a procedural object. And again, my mouse is making funky movements. So I'm gonna place it there, and I wanna align it perfectly with the road to not have that gap there. So something like this, okay? And by holding control, we can make duplicates of this object. Now I messed up the rotation, so pardon me, but you get the idea. Okay, so I'm gonna try to arrange them just a bit better so it's easier for you to follow. I'm not gonna be perfect, but yeah, I went in a different angle than the map grid. Okay, something like that. We can just get rid of this one. So let's say I want to add a building here. Okay, so let's find this one, because I know this is good. And I'm going to convert it into a PO, but first I'm going to place it here like so, and then I click on this building and I convert it into a PO with move it. Now obviously this is much higher than I need it to be, and let's add a retaining wall here just for good looks. So let's make this the same height as the road here, maybe just a bit higher, hide the grass, and let's place it over here, kind of like that. Okay, we can have a small park here, some flowers or whatever, but this building is getting in the way. Now what I want is obviously to not show over here, and I don't like those things either, so we can just go into edit mode and move those. Okay, it worked. And I forgot this node here. Okay, and what can we do? We can either scale it down, like I mentioned before. You know, this is not gonna look good on different parts of the building. On this one is okay because it keeps the same faces on the front side, so that kind of works. Okay, that kind of works for this model, but not everything. I very very rarely use the scale it, so we can do that. But I don't like how this building goes over here on the top, so I want this smaller in size, on height I mean. We can go to scale and scale it down until it's not visible anymore, basically like this, but now it doesn't look so good anymore. What I like to do is go into customization, okay, and now we can position the camera so we can see like the top part of the building, the vertices, and we can just or you can just go manually and select like the top part, just hold the camera in the good position and move them like so, select all those. This is extremely tedious, I'm just showing you as an example here. Usually you just position the camera in a way that you can see all of those. Again, you have to play a lot with this and figure out on your own how to select different things. Oh, and I made a mistake by unselecting them. My apologies. It's just because my mouse does random things most of the time. And what I'm seeing extra, because when I look like this, I see extra vertices here, are those things, the vents. So I'm just gonna select those and place them really low in the ground, just so we don't have to deal with them anymore. Okay, and now if we look like this, we align the camera trying to see like the front face. Okay, so we can select all those vertices here and move them down a little bit. And now we are almost intersecting with another row of vertices. So keeping the camera straight, I'm selecting the next row. Okay, moving down, selecting those, maybe something like that. And this is starting to look much more like how I need it to be. Okay, and I want it about here. This seems like a good size. But one more thing, I don't like this part. This part is showing there. I don't like that. So what can we do? Can we get rid of that? Well, can I throw it in the ground? I can, however, it's taking the entire thing with it, so the entire roof. Maybe I selected the wrong vertex. Let's see if I select this one. Okay, that kind of works. How about this one? That doesn't work. It's not the correct one. Let's try this one. Okay, so we cannot do that. We have to be clever about this. So what I'm gonna do, obviously this vertex here is those edges, so we cannot move that. But we can deal with this in a clever way. So I'm gonna move those in the middle of the building, just so they are not seen by the camera and all that. And we're gonna do the same for all of those vertices here. I'm gonna press page up, page down to move them lower in the ground, and then I'm just gonna drag everything in the middle. So let me do this quickly. Page down. Page down and move them inwards. And page down. Okay, something like that. And those ones. Over here where everything is hidden, we can be more careless about it, but usually I try to not disturb the other vertexes too much, because who knows what else is gonna move. So, and inwards. Go inwards with that one, and page down and inwards. Something like that. Okay. Oh, and we have those at the top. And that's about it. Okay, so now it looks like a mess, but what we can do is make a cube. If you don't have those, click the link in the description. You definitely need those procedural object, the basic objects. I think they actually come with the mod. Anyway, convert into PO, I'm gonna assign it the texture. We're gonna talk about textures and all that in the next episode. But for now, let's just align this properly over here. Okay, like so, kind of, pretty much. And I'm just gonna move this into position. And we go into customization mode, and I'm just gonna make like a thin, a very small, thin roof here. So, something like that. I'm not gonna spend time now to make it extremely accurate and beautiful, but you get the idea, alright? So, something like that. It's showing up on the front side, I'm gonna move it a bit backwards. And I just hold control, duplicate this object, place it over there. And move it a bit back, and something like this. Okay? Again, not making it perfect, but you get the idea. So now we have like a better roof here. And maybe I don't like the color. We can apply the same technique. We can go into color mode and let's make it a bit darker and maybe more on the brown side. Something like this. It kind of matches the building. And another cool thing, I want to apply this color to this object here. This concrete one. So we can store this color. You can click store, and now it's stored in the first cell. It's always going to be the last one in the first cell. So if I add another one here, it's going to go there. Okay, so now I want to apply this color. Okay, over here I click that button and I store this one, and the same over here, and that's looking already much better. And now we can just maybe move this retaining wall over there, and now we have something which is not showing up through the roof over there, through the grass and all that. We can apply some trees here, some flowers, and this building looks quite good here. So now we can just copy all of those. Make sure you have the correct objects. We can copy. I'm deselecting, I'm pressing Ctrl V, and then I'm holding H to have the same height as that object there. Okay, so I'm just gonna align them with the mouse here and do like a row of those and whatever. Okay, and then you can go crazy on the top side and do whatever goes in your imagination. Okay, so those are like the basic principles on how to manipulate the vertices, how to work with them in your favor, and how to create interesting things. This is just the beginning. This is hopefully you learned something. This is just the foundation, and in the next episode we're gonna go into a bit more advanced things, how to work with textures and text customization and all that kind of stuff. And in the last episode we're gonna make something a bit more advanced, make our own object and manipulate it in a different way, in an interesting way. But I hope you guys liked it. I definitely want you to guys to try and make something like a small homework for you. make something with procedural objects if you never did. Do something, and if you do that, take a screenshot and drop it on either my Discord, or you can drop it in the YouTube comments. I'm really curious to see what you guys are gonna make. And for the last episode, I'm gonna give you like a big homework, and you're gonna have to do something with a specific object that I'm gonna tell you, and apply the things that you learned so far. Okay, if you guys enjoyed the video, like, share, subscribe, all that kind of stuff, and I will see you in the next one. Have a good day. Bye bye.